Hello, beautiful people. It's your girl Shakara Danye, and I am back with a message. So today is October 22nd, and it is already a lovely day because we claim it to be that anyway. I'm just coming on here to give a random read, a random upload. So let's see what's in the energy. Continuing on, as you can see, I already have a spread laid out, and because I wasn't even planning to do a video right now, and that's why I'm not on camera, but I just wanted to get on here and give this message of what's going to continue to unfold, because it's already everything. Okay, so on the bottom of the deck, we gonna get right into it. Prosperity begins. So you might have been going through a season where you just like, okay, any day now, God, what we doing here? And now things are popping up. Prosperity, abundance, because you planted this seed. And this seed, you ain't know if it was gonna sprout out. You just had to keep the faith and keep on watering the plant, and then eventually it's gonna sprout. And so now this prosperity is popping up. Peaches represent abundance and prosperity, and so you have to know it, you have to claim it, and you have to be it. That you have to sit there diligently and water this plant and water the seed and water it and watch it grow. And you thinking it's a plant, it's a whole tree, baby. Like, come on, get into it. And after that, we have intuition. So that blind trust, because you are trusting your intuition now. Things are getting ticked off to you, and you listening now. You are not going against yourself. You're trusting yourself, because how can you say that you trust God and you don't trust yourself? So now you have changed perspective, and you are trusting that without a shadow of a doubt, things are coming in and is flourishing you. This victory and success is yours, and so you at the top of the mountain claiming it, sounding the alarm on what's yours unapologetically, without fear, without doubt. All right. So it's all coming through. All right, so continue to trust this process, continue to stand and sit in your power. Solar plexus came out, and this chakra governs your personal power and how you feel about yourself, your self-esteem, your courage to sit in your purpose and your power and walk in it. It's time to take up your throne and know who you are and whose you are. So if you're having trouble with this, wear yellow, eat yellow foods, and affirm over your life, affirming affirmations of, I am powerful, I am safe to walk in my power and my purpose. Yellow, 3 represents mind, body, and soul. It represents you. So that was nice to see. And then we have authority. 4 is easily becoming one of my favorite numbers because of what it represents. It represents stability, it represents loyalty, it represents protection. All around, you are coming into new levels of being around more people, places, and things that is bringing stability in your life. You are stable. You are these things as well, and you are coming into the levels that you are surrounded by these people as well. That not only you are supported and stable and everything, but those that you surround yourself with. And you have to have this type of authority in your life as well, because you can't just be all friendly, happy, willy-nilly in these next levels that you are going in. And the processes and stages before that, you had to know that. You had to be in a position of standing your ground and not being afraid to stand your ground. So this authority that you had to develop in yourself, it had to take some time. It wasn't gonna happen overnight, because you was this big-hearted person, this caring and considerate person for all things and all people, even when they wasn't to you. And so yeah, your team had to step in and be like, okay, yeah, we love that for you, but you gotta have some discernment, you gotta have some authority, you gotta have some aggression a little bit, because no. And I'm saying that at 5, 5, 5, so some things had to change, and so they had to put you through this type of initiation of standing your ground and being comfortable in that, to not get walked all over, and to really place yourself in these protective realms. And they are placing you in these protective realms, that you are highly protected, and you know this, because the people that have been unjustly doing you wrong when you was just nothing but kind and considerate to them, they getting their karma, and they are regretting that now, because they know, oh, I ain't have to do that. I ain't have to do it like that. I ain't have to do them like that. Yeah. And so they might try to come back, and your team is standing right there like this, authoritative. Come back where? The gate, the door, all of that, closed, locked away. They can't even find it. And so, yeah, you had to get this type of authoritative stance in your own life, in your own mind, in your own heart, to protect yourself and the things and the places that you are going. You can't just be the same old pushover or just passive aggressive. No, you got to learn how to be authoritative and still be you. You don't have to, you know, do the most, but know that you are protected. Know that you're not just about to come and play in my face no more. You have to know that. And so with this authority here, it represents you and your team standing behind you, that you are protected, and you have this auric field, your energy field, your auric field is protected. And that's the type of royal in your blood, like the royal columns. This always stands out to me, these columns. You are fortified in protection, you are fortified in stability, you are fortified in whatever it is that's for you. And then we have moving on. That moving on, you are actively moving towards better. That you've moved on from the things that no longer serve your purpose, and this was needed, because it was keeping you stuck and stagnant. It was keeping you in the dark, and you needed to balance out that you have light and dark in you. So you had to move. You had to see, all right, I gotta balance this out. I gotta see where I need to balance things out. And so you had to get to moving. So moving on is action. It's going forward and moving forward and moving on and upward. Six represents harmony. It represents reliability. That you are coming into a position where you're able to rely on yourself, because you're speaking up for yourself. This blue represents throat chakra. That your throat chakra has been activating. As long as you're moving forward, you are coming into new foundations of knowing how to speak up for yourself. Speaking up and standing on that. That you hold the compass to where it is that you want to go. And you are confident in yourself in this. That your head up, you are looking straight ahead and looking forward and knowing that, okay, I got this in my hands and I can create where it is that I want to go. And you're going towards it. You are going and moving without delay. Then we have wish fulfillments again. I love to see this card, like I said, because look at this. We got double portion. We standing on the growth. And also, this is a season that you are standing in it and you don't even know it. That you've been standing in it, but you had to go through the motions. You had to go through the cleansing and pruning process because all that was meant for you is for you, and some people can't enjoy that with you. Some people was not meant to enjoy that with you, so you have to get in this position alone to see, all right, this is for me, and I deserve this treasure. I deserve to have it for me and enjoy it for me, and not always trying to give it away. That it's okay that the people that I was trying to bring up with me that wasn't meant for me, it's okay, because they got their own path to go on, whether that be whatever. It ain't my concern. But for me, I'm standing in it. I'm standing on this growth that it took. It took the long nights of crying and being alone. It took the just really working on myself. It took them days to see. And now I'm standing in it and on it for myself. And I am happy about it. 9 represents completion. It represents being able to end one thing and hop into new beginnings, new found discoveries, new things that I'm standing on. And it is a treasure. It's good. It's pleasurable. And double portion. And right after that, new beginnings. And you standing in it. Like, it's the beautiful thing. It's the beautiful thing we have here. New beginnings. One thing in so that new can begin. That endings are not always bad. Tower moments, things falling apart are not always bad, because if that foundation wasn't good enough, then yes, it has to be pulled up from underneath you. It has to fall apart from you so that better can be built, that you can build a better world, so that you can be standing in a better world. You might be an earth sign. So it's all in your hands. Action, that you are going and taking the leap and going towards whatever it is that you set your mind to, and you know that this is for you. And then we have recognition and rewards again. 3 represents mind, body, and soul. That you are being placed on this platform for a reason. That you can do it. You are the one that is meant to do it. To be the advocate, to be the comforter, to be the encourager. You are the one that's meant to do it. And so you have these rewards and recognitions coming in for the diligent work that you've put forth behind closed doors that nobody even knew about. That this red represents root chakra, that you are rooted down in security, that it's safe for you to be you. It's safe for you to walk in your purpose and stand in it because you've earned this platform. You've earned it. You've earned the recognition, even if you don't want it. You've earned being able to be the shining star that you are. You got to know it. You got to trust it. You have to be in it, fully engulfed in it. And your gifts are making room for you. That this chain, this jewelry, this is for you. Own it without delay. 14, 14. Mirroring numbers. So this is looking real good already, and I am excited to continue. Like, let's see. So let's confirm and clarify more on what it is that is in the energy of today alone. Like, today alone, it represents stability. When you deduce down 22, it represents 4. That 4 energy is just wrapped up in all good positivity. Like, you are bringing in the abundance, the celebration. You getting ready to celebrate even more. That little wins are turning into big wins, and you are celebrating you. Even if it's just you celebrating you, you celebrating you, because you have a reason to, just off the strength of you being you, baby. You have to know it, okay? And don't be afraid. So let's see. Solar plexus chakra, clarify solar plexus energy. See? Action, Jupiter, beginnings. So this is Aries energy, I want to say, and Wand energy. So Ace of Wands is what I'm picking up on. Action, like I said, that you have to stand in this power. You have to act on this power now, that you, whether you sitting on the throne and you just allowing God to handle it, like God said, it's handled, it's already done. You don't have to do too much, baby. So you sitting in your throne, or it's time to go. It's time to act upon what it is that the ideas are in your head, and they are blazing because they're ready for you to go. And so you got to do this action and have the courage to do this. And so, yeah, Jupiter energy is about expansion. You are expanding. You are expanding beyond your wildest dreams, and it's gonna be happening quickly. With these new beginners out here twice, like, it's time. It's you standing in it. You standing in these new beginnings, and it's time to take up the power and go for it. Fire represents refining. Refinery, like, you burning off the old ways of thinking, the old ways of doing things, and you going towards new. And you having this new courage in yourself to go and have this power about yourself. Because who else gonna do it? Is the energy. Like, who else gonna do it for me? So I gotta get it together and get the fuck up and not be scared to go see and do. Clarify authority. Clarify authority for me, Spirit. See, it just be working out so well. What I say with authority, like, you have to stand your ground to separate from these things that no longer serve your purpose. This is pertaining to commitment. This is a woman in a wedding dress. So it's pertaining to some commitments, relationships, whether that be romantic or platonic, family dynamics, everything that is no longer serving your purpose, you have to get away from it. And this rocking horse right here, the back and forth, you have to cut that out. No matter if you was longing for it to still be in your life, or whether they were longing for you to still be in their life, you have to separate. You have to get away in order to bring forth the things that God has for you. You had to stand in it, and you had to stand on it. They had to stand on it. However they treated you in that season where you needed them most, they got to stand on that shit now. And that's on period, because ain't no back and forth. When that door closed, it's done. It's a done deal. And they had to realize that. You had to realize that. And you had to get over longing for people, places, and things that just wasn't good for you. You had to get over it. You had to forgive yourself. You had to release it. And the projection, this is also a projection scream. So you had to get away from people projecting upon you what they wanted for you and what they thought that that's all you was. No, you more than what your ex was to you. You more than that bond. You more than that friendship that you thought they had with you. You more than that. And so you have to sit with yourself and reflect upon it and really stand and set some boundaries with yourself. And your team was right there backing you. Like, I don't give a hell what it was that they thought they had with you and wanted and would. And they thought that they was going to keep it forever. They didn't, you know, them typical vows, till death to do us part. They thought it was going to be forever. But your team has something different. You had something different and showed they had something different. Like, oh, yeah, okay. And got them right on out your life because they wasn't meant to go up with you. Clarify, moving on, spirit, please. Clarify, moving on. And as I'm cutting the deck, I'm seeing this harmony, conflict, and all that. So yeah, you have to get away from them people that was causing conflict and disharmony in your life. Clarify, moving on. So, remembering, awakening, and ancestor alchemy. So with this coming out for clarity on moving on, you had to remember who you was. You had to remember and awaken to this ancestor power within you, and you had to go towards the light. You had to transmute and learn how to clear the storm. Alchemy. You had to be able to release what no longer served your purpose and remember who you are. Reach towards the light and go towards the light and move on from things that no longer served your purpose. So now that you're remembering who you is, you seeing the light. You seeing the knowledge, the wisdom, the power that's within you already. And your ancestors are with you, helping you with this transition, these new beginnings, these things that it might have been hard. It might have been a couple seasons where you just like, look, y'all, let's go ahead out. Let me know something. So they had to, you know, get you in order. They was right along with you, with them crying days, them nights that you ain't even. You ain't even know if you was gonna make it. You was just like, all right, I'm trusting the process, but this process is kind of a little, it's getting a little tense here. But it was needed so that you can go towards better and transcend and go higher. Clarify wish fulfillments or fulfillment of wishes. Mm-hmm. That's what I like to see. Earth, Ace of Pentacles, material force. So some material force, the manifestations that you want, earth energy, you're grounded in this. You're grounded in stability. You're grounded in luxury. You're grounded in things that is going to work out for you. That whatever it is that you put out into the universe is coming. Your wishes are being fulfilled. You might be a earth sign, like I said, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Memories, nostalgia also came out. So it might be a love interest that is coming to fruition. Like, you are they wish fulfillment. They are your wish fulfillment. So a relationship might be coming through. A past relationship might be coming back to return to you with the memories. So just be mindful. If it's not what you want, don't entertain it. Close that shit off. It don't matter if they from your past, if they still on the same shit, it's a no for me. Stand on it. It don't matter if they trying to project and portray to be something that they not. Your intuition is strong at this point. Use that motherfucker, okay? Hear me clear. Don't just be allowing it just because, oh, it ain't from my past. I know them. It ain't. Spirit said, no. Immediately, no. All right? So, be mindful. But if they are changed and you know, they showing you different and better, then all right, trust yourself in knowing that you can choose wisely this time. All right, clarify new beginnings for me, Spirit. So don't be closed off and resistant and guarded to this new beginning. You got to be able to know, okay, this is a new chapter. This is a new cycle. And I'm going to go for it. I'm going to leap in it. 2 feet in. Whole body in. Mind, body, and soul. I ain't going to think too much into it. Because if you be too guarded, too closed off, too resistant, then you gonna be stuck in the same cycle. You gonna be stuck again doing the same shit when it was an opportunity for you to jump all in to do something new, new beginnings. So it's up to you what you gonna do. You gonna be like this person right here, like regretting, like, damn, I missed the opportunity again. No, we're going to be like this person, ready to go, action, on the feet, going, seeing, and doing. It's up to you. Choose wisely. All right? So don't be so closed off that you miss the opportunity to be rewarded, to have the abundance in the celebration that you want, that you've been asking for. Like, come on now, make it make sense. You've been asking for this, so why would you be so close off that you just can continue to miss the opportunity? We ain't doing that. We ain't self-sabotaging. That's a lot of self-sabotaging energy right here. We want to let that go. You see this? Exhale it. Let it go. We are taking the opportunity and trusting and speaking life into these new opportunities that is good as well. Because when you sit back and realize all the other opportunities that you missed in the past, think back. What was you saying? Oh, it might not work out. Or if it don't work out, you were already speaking negativity into it before it worked out. No. In the dough. Whether you know it or not, feel it or not, you gonna make it a point to speak abundance, speak life into the situation. And whatever come of it is gonna be because you put the positivity into it. You put the force of working out for you into it. You feel me? You catching what I'm putting down? So don't count yourself out before you even get in the motion. All right, like, stop on that. You gotta realize that it's real out here, that speaking things over your life is real. So always speak and think and feel and do the positive of what you want to come into your life. Clarify recognition and reward for me, Spirit. Thank you for your... So this popping out even before I shuffle. Open to receive. All you gotta do is be open. Open for it. Recognition and reward. Be open for this. open. So, self-care energy. But the energy of I'm taking care of myself and I'm putting forth the effort into myself. So I'm speaking life. That's what that is. Take care of yourself. And while you're taking care of yourself, speak life into your endeavors. Speak life into you. Look in the mirror and speak life into you. And then Ace of Wands. So we have this action and ace energy out here twice. So yeah, it's time to go, to see and to do, to act upon this with diligence. You might be a Leo, Aries, and Sagittarius, a fire sign. Ace of Wands is about taking the risk, the leap, going for it. You might be wanting to change your hair. I've been seeing a lot of ginger heads. Like, if you want to go that route and do that color, go for it. You might be a water sign or a fire sign as well. So it's time to be open to receive these things that you are wanting, and it's time to take care and take action on this. Heavy fire sign, heavy fire energy, and water energy. Release, surrender to this. When you surrender, it might not feel good at the time, because your mind is thinking in lack at the time that spirit is saying release, let go. But once you do release and you let go and you just have this energy of freedom, like, this is free. Free your mind of the hot, fiery energy that's shut up in your bones. Free your mind and surrender fully and trust that they got you. That everything is everything because they got you, okay? So we're going to see this handy dandy anchor, and we got two out here. Okay, so you have to know that you are anchored down in stability, baby. That this anchor represents water sign, water energy, and with this wheel, it represents chakras. So work on your chakras, make sure that they are unblocked and they are clear for all of these good things to come in. Heavy on the water energy as well. Water represents cleansing, it represents flow. Be fluid in this energy, be fluid in this season, this Scorpio season coming up. Death and rebirth, let it happen. Let these things physically fall off of you, mentally fall off of you, emotionally fall off of you. What no longer serve your purpose that's blocking you, allow it to fall off of you. No matter how hard it hurt to let go, just let it go, because better is on the way. God is not going to leave you broke or desolate. Hear me clear. It's just not in the plans for you to just be out here all bad. Especially if you a divine person of high vibrations. That you've been putting out goodness and gladness all through the land. How do you think God is going to repay you? God is going to be repaying you with more than you can even take in all at once. Hear me clear. Okay? So we have G-S-V-K-D-I-M-O. So Sumi, Miss. So, like I said earlier, don't be so closed off that you continuing to miss these motherfucking opportunities, okay? Go towards the light. Go towards what feel good. Go towards what's right, all right? It's I've been picking up heavy gang relations, you know. So them gang members stepping, your ancestors and spirit guides don't play about you. So they step in. They in this authoritative position with you, and they ready to take a bitch out behind you. Okay, so I just advise people to really be on the good side of karma these days. Okay, so someone is missing you, and they might be coming in to tell you that, and these initials might be their initials. So there's that in the charms. So yeah, I just wanted to get on here and give that reading. That was immaculately amazing, and I hope that you take it in and take it for what it is, of what you desire and require. Okay, and I will be back for more. I got monetized on Facebook today, so woohoo, celebrating that with reels so that I can bring in the money. All right, multiple streams of income is my lot in life, and I'm claiming it as mine, and it is so. Ashe, so shall it be, and it is so. So there's that with that. So yeah, I'm gonna be back, and you're gonna see my lovely face later. So if you haven't already, please comment, like, and subscribe. It's your card, Danye, and until next time, peace.